Are you kidding me?
Here's a shot that I believe they score! McRae shoots, he scores! To the goal, shoots, he scores! Make it 4 for 24!
It's time for the show. Forget everything that you know. It's impossible to resist. You ain't seen nothing like this.
Game of the week on TSN returns to Ontario as Hamilton takes center stage, as do the Toronto Rock, welcoming in the Halifax Thunderbirds in this Alterna Cup rivalry. And it's a big night for that man they call Dangerous Dan Dawson.
Dawson playing his 300th career game, just the second player to reach the big number 300. John Tavares, the only other one to do so.
Great goaltender matchup in week 6. Week 7, no different. Warren Hill for the Halifax Thunderbirds. The starting goaltenders presented by Guaranteed Rate. At the other end, of course, the veteran. It'll be Nick Rose for the Toronto Rock head-to-head. Made 38 saves against the Buffalo Bandits in a losing effort that the Rock are trying to bounce back from a week ago. And John Abbott, Pat Gregoire, and Ashley Docking, the crew in Hamilton tonight for the Thunderbirds. It's all about finding out if they remember how to play this game again.
But for Dan Dawson, it's a special night for him. I mentioned 300, but another note to watch, he needs 2 points to pass John Grant Jr. for second all-time in points. Yeah, John, it's going to be a tall task for him to catch Johnny T in points there, but he just continues to climb and climb these record books, and he finally gets back into the lineup after being on COVID protocol, and he is going to be a huge boost offensively, but also a leader as well.
No stranger, the two men in the face-off circle. As T.D. Erland gets it going against Jake Withers.
Jake Withers, one of the best, if not the best, face-off man in the game.
Halifax starts it early. First shift, first goal. And a 1-0 lead. Austin Shanks, welcome back to the lineup.
Welcome back indeed. We talked about a lot of the COVID protocols that the Rock have having to deal with, but Austin Shanks comes back to the lineup due to injury, and Tyson Bell just finds him off the bench. That one goes right by the low glove, the toughest save for a goalie to make, but Nick Rose certainly going to want that one back. But welcome back, Austin Shanks, getting a little boost to the offense, which probably really didn't need much of a boost as their righties have been on fire all season so far.
And what we were alluding to earlier, Pat, as you know, is that the last time these two teams met was week 2. That's the last game Halifax has played in, so 36 days. My goodness, that's the layoff for the Thunderbirds. And, well, no rush shown on that first possession. And that has been a bit of a storyline, Pat, on the flip side for the Rock as well.
Big time. They have not led in the first quarter at all this year. It's something that the coaching staff wanted to really fix, and they're going to have to try to get going here with their first offensive possession.
Shriver and Dawson back in the lineup. Shriver corralling up top. Nice move. Let's it rip. That's wide of the goal of Warren Hill. We mentioned that Shriver is welcome their first child in the family, so no trip to Buffalo in week 6. And those interesting predictions here, Pat, I'll leave the floor to you.
Yeah, with these two strong defensive teams, I think the under 22 and a half might be a good play, but Halifax, that line has shifted a lot due to the fact that, as we mentioned, Toronto dealing with some serious COVID protocols.
Look at this break in transition, and Warren Hill shuts him down. My goodness, that was a sprint from Adam Jay all the way to the length of the floor. And Toronto had a good look to try and tie this one up early. Jalen Rogers to the side, and they do. Nice little backdoor slam from Craig.
And this is something that Toronto really wanted to focus on coming into this game, getting production from their lefties. You look at their rosters, at the stat sheets, it's all coming from the righties, and yes, it does drive here as you see Jalen Rogers with a beautiful move, fires to the back end, and great awareness by Jalen Rogers to recognize Austin Shanks, a forward, getting caught on defense. He's just foaming at the mouth. Let me take this guy one-on-one, and then finds Craig on the back door there.
And again, last week, the Rock in Buffalo, it was Rogers that consistently activated, maybe even more so when you think of the names that are out tonight. No Reid Reinhold, no Justin Scott, no Aaron Forster, no Rob Hellier. So, my goodness, no Latrell Harris on the defensive side of the ball as well. Or Slade. So Toronto continues to try and manage with a ever-changing roster. I know that's nothing new in the professional sports realm these days, but you probably see a lot of Rogers working offensively even more so than him.
Mark Conkerton getting his first shift offensively. His shot got blocked there. He was picked up later this week, or earlier this week, I should say, trying to, you know, be that reinforcement on the left-hand side.
He's cut to the inside. And what a finish there by Bushi as he puts it over top of Rose, and it's almost next possession goal at this point.
Starting to regret saying the under might have been a play, John. These guys have come out fast and furious, and a guy who has been so good all season long, Chris Bushi. And it's been these two guys right here, the dynamic with these righties. A great feed from the rookie. As you see, Bushi, how is he even able to grab that ball? Still gets that shot off. Bushi having himself an unbelievable season. But get that ball for Connor Watson, the rookie. His first game, his first assist.
A couple of first-timers debuting. Hope it gets any better than the San Diego goaltending pair, though. My goodness, some great stories across the NLL.
Talking about some debuts, another debut to look for. Ryan Tarafenko, the guy who blocked that shot, getting his first action in the National Lacrosse League here for Halifax.
Nice to see Cody Jameson back, and Rose will corral this one.
Yeah, Jameson missed the first two games due to injury. Didn't go on the IR because he was so close. Having a conversation with him earlier this week, he said, Patty, I'm ready to go. I'm hungry to get back to my client.
Driver sends it over. That's a rip from long range and a nice stop by Warren Hill. Making it look easy already. Pairing up is Graham Hossick. Excited about this Hossick-Withers pairing on the defensive side. My goodness, that is a lot to contend with. Toronto's going to try and break through that. His forward pass. Rogers quick to dish it off as well. Rogers gets it back, slices in, shoots. What a good look there from Jalen Rogers.
John, you saw this Rock team last week in Buffalo. Boy, it seems like they're playing with a lot more pace, and that's the way they want to play. They want to dictate the pace. Matt Sawyer said, in all four of our games so far, we allow the other teams to decide how the game is going. I think now they're starting. They want to get this into a track meet here.
Jameson in tight, looking to try and find a net drive, and a little behind the back, nearly surprised Rose. Quick transition, and Hale will turn another one away. This one from Brad Cree, who just decided to carry all the way up. Nice little pass to activate another offensive look. Catching Toronto at the bench a little bit. Weir Carter, his first game this season, trying to help out the Toronto Rock.
Chris Greer, another one of these youngsters getting into the lineup for the Rock. Phil Mazzucca as well, just down the QEWA, Oakville, Ontario native. So a lot of fresh faces in this Rock lineup.
Rogers kicks out to Dawson. Wanted to return it to Rogers.
Going
to
be a penalty
here,
John.
Pick up a call. Halifax has come out early thanks to Austin Shanks and crew.
Alterna Savings. Alterna offers easy, more personal financial services and puts the good in banking. Visit alterna.ca to learn more. By fanatics.ca, the NLL's home for officially licensed everything. Visit fanatics.ca today. And by Guaranteed Rate. If you believe it, you can do it. Guaranteed Rate. Believe you will.
Big night to recognize that man, Dan Dawson. For more on his story, let's join Ashley Dockey.
Dangerous Dan Dawson, it's a fitting nickname for somebody who's about to hit two major career markers here tonight. So I asked him, Dan, how'd you get that nickname? He said he wishes the story was more exciting. He was simply minding his business, stretching pregame in his rookie season, and the in-arena announcer came up to him and said, "You're Dangerous Dan." The guy just liked the fact that the double D alliteration rolled off his tongue. Dan said, "I was not, in fact, dangerous. I was a healthy scratch 5 games that season and had 6 points as a D guy." But he came into his own and eventually earned the nickname that we all know and love here tonight, guys.
Thanks very much, Ashley. Great little backstory awesome. To that. You know, it's so natural. I just assumed he'd had it his whole life. Dangerous Dan does roll.
Certainly does. I know the Rock are going to be looking for him to be dangerous on this power play, something that they've been pretty successful early on this season, but without Treiber, without Dawson, they've kind of struggled.
Well, no Hellier, just as quick as you say that Treiber and Dawson are back, and he was certainly all the ball was running through him in Buffalo.
Challen Rogers is going to come up here and quarterback the top. He's got such an unbelievable shot, especially for a defender.
Treiber rotates, trying to pick a spot, dishes off. That one off the post, close on that Rock power play. Spread around nicely. Rogers. Treiber behind the back to Rogers, shoots, stopped by Hill.
That first one definitely was the post, but we know Hill making the saves. And boy, John, for a big body, he is so athletic. The guy is built like an offensive lineman. He's got the feet like an offensive lineman as well.
Great bucket from Hill as well.
Yes.
Coming a little off the mark, but pushes Toronto start from their own end. Eric Fennell. Working with the Thunderbirds, down a man. Rock on the power play, trying to tie this one up. Still some time to work with. Schreiber looks in. Low shot, fended off by Hill, and we've got a little extra shot after the fact.
Tyson Bell is going to want to watch out there as Chris Williams, the official, tell him, just get to the box, Tyson. No extracurriculars here, but looks like they actually are, in fact, going to get two in the box here. So a glorious opportunity here for the Rock to tie things up. Actually, no, sorry, I apologize. Trevor Smith came out just a bit too early. There's still 1 second left, but here's the penalty. We'll watch it come back right there, and yeah, no doubt the official's going to get that every single time. Wasn't near the play, so.
Dawson, nice move. Couldn't find that second opening he was looking for, though. Thunderbirds in transition, speeding it up here. Peeling off is David Brock. He eats some clock here. Takes a couple of whacks to pick some time away. What effort by Brock, who tried to call his own number. Why not?
I absolutely love seeing that. A defensive player on the kill go end to end and then draw a penalty, even things up. That's what you want. You do not need to force it, take it in the net. I mean, if you get the chance, take it here. But Brock, such a big body. This is not the reason why Kurt Stiers, the general manager of the Thunderbirds, went out to get him, but he's draped all over by two players there. They can't get the ball off him. Instead, now we'll go 4-on-4. And with the way that we've seen Halifax play on offense this year with the speedsters, this could play into their hand.
Bounce off the boards. Looking for a shimmy shake and a low ball works. Austin Shanks again. Running up the score for Halifax.
You think head coach Mike Kersey's fired up that Austin Shanks is back in the lineup? Already two goals here and we're not even out of the first frame. Shanks, such a dynamic player. The one thing that has really held him back from being elite is he can never stay in the lineup. Always just bad luck with injuries. But it's the stuff like this that makes him such a special player, an unbelievable shooter. Noble just giving him way too much space. You cannot give him that much space. Peterson, just that little pick there, frees up. Maybe a little bit of a miscommunication from Cree as well. But sharpshooters like that, John, you cannot give them that much time and space. They're going to take it every time.
And you kind of alluded to it wisely, Pat, that the open floor might work in favor of Halifax, and they took that space. Tarasenko dishes, then heads to the bench. Halifax setting it up. They'll have a brief power play if nothing else changes. Jameson stops short, takes letting it go, dishes over. And Rose standing his ground, puts that back out into play. Rock will try to push it up the floor. Three. Cradles, play changing behind him. Hands it over to Craig.
Haven't mentioned it yet, but Latrell Harris also out of the lineup. A huge, huge defender for this Rock team. So look to see maybe Brad Free play an even bigger role, which is saying a lot considering the guys all over the floor.
And Dan Craig as well. He's actually the leading scorer for the Rock now with the players that are out. Doubled back by Armstrong. Let's wait for the seconds to tick off, and so indeed, sprinting out of the box is Bell. Halifax, a man up. Just about 20 seconds in a abbreviated power play. This one skips to Rose. He's comfortable handling that.
Yeah, Cody Jameson trying that patented little skip pass to the crease. Austin Shanks just not expecting it. And good job by the Rock as they'll kill off all the clock here. We're going to go back to 5-on-5 lacrosse.
Dawson, now trying to make a move. Spots the man out of the box. That would have been a redemption song for DeSnew. And now we've got a fight.
That's David Brock and Mitch DeSnew.
Not quite the way things ended in Buffalo with everybody on the floor getting involved, but this is pretty early for Destoux. And Brock giving it a go. And Brock, an extra little shot at the end before the officials come in.
And that's a spirited bout between the two. David Brock, the veteran, one of the newcomers, as I mentioned, picked him up. That's his former teammate. David Brock played last season for the Toronto Rock. Both guys, not known for Chuck and Nux, but both guys definitely tough players, tough customers, as you can see there as they drop the mitts there.
Well, there's hostility, there's gamesmanship, and then there's an edge to be gained somewhere. Depends how you add it up in that instance. Sawyer looks on.
Chow Rogers mentioned earlier, you know, there is a new rivalry brewing between these two teams. We saw a fight last time they met, Mungo Thompson, and of course, Billy Hostrauser had a spirited bout. So wouldn't be surprised if we see things start to get even more chippy here.
It was an 11-7 win for the Thunderbirds, and Peterson with six goals in that one to run it up. Rogers. Again, Dawson over to the far side. There's the pick from Mann. Rogers. Trying to get to the inside. Dawson takes a look, lets it go, and Hill read that one all the way. Not biting on the far side net drive from Zach Manns. Rock in position as the Thunderbirds make their way up the floor. Jameson. Looked like he was going to go himself, and another second. Rose had to make a couple of saves.
Cody, that's you, Cody!
Green light given. Tried to pick that far side. A little off the mark. 59 points last year from the big man, but missed a lot of time. That one off the bar and out. Rock pushing the pace in transition, trying to get it together quickly, and that one stayed out somehow.
There's that athleticism I talked about with Warren Hill going pipe to pipe, somehow getting a leg.
Maybe even a foot. Six.
Might have been a foot. You're right, John. But that's just that athleticism. You see two big goalies, Nick Rose, definitely more of a goalie that likes to play his angles, whereas Warren Hill, the guy is just all over his net.
Easy chest stop there. Not forcing Rose to do too much against Jackson. Rogers some room, lets it fly. Nice save by Hill. Turning that one out and turning it up in Hamilton. These two rivals getting dirty and dusty on TSN.
We talked about how the Thunderbirds were getting a big boost with Cody Jamison, their captain, but it's been Austin Shanks getting involved in the scoring and his return to the lineup. Two beautiful goals. The former Ohio State Buckeye making his presence felt here in the Hammer.
With more on Shanks, let's rejoin Ashley Dockey.
Yeah, guys, I ran into Austin pregame, and he was, like, so disappointed that he was not able to play the second game and most of the first with his team. He said everyone was talking about, oh, we haven't played in 600 days. Well, how does it feel? How do you think it feels to miss another 30 days? So he's very happy to be back, and obviously he hasn't missed a beat here tonight with two goals so far.
Thanks, Ashley. That's first points of the season. Look pretty good for Shanks, the former Whitby Warrior. Toronto trying to put a net drive and some finish on that one, but couldn't quite tuck it home.
Here we go.
Atmosphere changes just a bit when there's no fans in the stands, Pat, and certainly the Rock trying to claw their way back into this first quarter.
Oh, are you kidding me? Austin Shanks.
Who else but Shanks again?
Unbelievable stuff. That's the hat trick. We are not even out of the first quarter, and the Buckeye is buzzing here at First Ontario Center. We'll see the rebound. He grabs his own rebound. Quick stick, bam, in the back of the net. We'll get a great look here. In and out of his stick. In hockey, we call that a one-timer. In lacrosse, it's a quick stick. And boy, does Austin Shanks have a quick stick.
Good hops, too.
Good hops, good mullet, good muzzy. That's what a lacrosse player is supposed to look like, John.
Well, he's fitting the bill, and we are happy to enjoy every second of Austin Shanks coming back to the lineup tonight. Great retrieval. Looks like he surprised Rose with the move he made there. Hill reaches back, doesn't have to twist himself up any more than he already did. Just finds a way to make that first stop so often.
He's so flexible. Every time he goes back like that, my body just hurts seeing him do that. All in the day's work for Warren Hill.
Trying to set it up. Toronto able to win that ball back, and Did he sneak it through? He did. That's a big goal for Weir. And they'll grab the ball for that man.
Chris Weir, the Niagara-on-the-Lake native, getting his first NLL action, getting his first NLL goal, and it comes in transition. Dan Craig got caught on defense, which isn't a bad thing because he's able to push transition, gets it over to Weir. Weir takes that shot, boom, right off that hip of Warren Hill. Hey, I know that's a defender, but that is a beautiful shot there by Weir. The rookie finally getting into the lineup, and it's plays like that. It's going to make Matt Sawyer's choices very tough next time they play, because you might want to keep that guy in the lineup.
Nice move from the 22-year-old. I didn't do him justice. I wasn't sure with the way that Warren Hill gets down if that made it all the way through, but he'll tell it a lot better.
Again, another transition goal for Toronto, playing with more pace. This is the MO of the Rock. They want to play fast. They want to play furious. Talking to Mike McCursey, the head coach of Halifax, said, we have to be aware of that.
And cut the lead in half again, and a little somersault barrel roll. Trying to add another just before the buzzer. Rock will pick it up, trying to add some speed up the floor.
Just a couple of seconds in between the shot clock and the game clock.
Dawson directing traffic. Rogers put the head down, didn't play off the shoulder, now shoots. Will make its way to the net. Mans recovers, side door shot, off the post. Mans again, time winding down here in the first quarter. Any late magic from Toronto? That one high, backhander on, and a stop at the buzzer for Warren Hill.
I don't even know how Mark Cockerton even got that shot off, John, but that just shows the skill. That's the reason why Jamie Douk, the GM of the Rock, went out and grabbed him.
Three goals from Austin Shanks, and the Halifax Thunderbirds lead the Toronto Rock by a pair on a big evening for Dan Dawson on TSN.
Lots of big game moments for that man, Tom Schreiber, but big life moments last week as well. For more on that, let's rejoin Ashley Docking.
Thank you so much, John. Tom Schreiber was not with Toronto in Buffalo last week, and not because of COVID protocols, which is what had him sidelined the previous game, but because he was with his wife, Kathleen, as the couple welcomed their first child, daughter Lily Grace. The beautiful picture that was shared on Instagram shows the happy and healthy family. Look at that little cutie, the newest member of Rock City. But listen, guys, the team is happy to help have him back. He's the leading scorer of Toronto. He's tied for 11th in the league in scoring with 10 other players, seven of whom have played at least 4 to 5 games. Schreiber, of course, 8 goals in 2 games.
Thanks, Ashley. And as Toronto gets ready to start the second quarter, showed that they were a little bit more proactive in trying to find the back of the net and claw their way back. But Pat, they certainly need the support from a guy like Schreiber against the additions or the returnees that Halifax has been able to put into the lineup.
No doubt about that. Schreiber, 8 goals so far this season in just 2 games played. It just shows you how important he is to this offense.
Cree's going to go for a run here. And a call coming up, I guess so, on DeSneu, who thought he had everything sewn up there.
Almost thought we were going to get a penalty shot there, but instead it's going to be a hold. So DeSneu doing a good job getting to the net, and John, we'll see a great look here. And yeah, no doubt, 110% they're going to call that. So we'll see, DeSneu takes it to the net. Withers gets the ball out of the stick, but anytime you have that extra hand off the stick, touch the body, the refs are going to call that, especially on a clear goal scoring opportunity there. So power play, they're going to have an opportunity here. Is the Toronto Rock, we'll see Chandler Rogers back at the point there playing that top. So it'll be interesting to see if Halifax tries to go into that diamond to take away the goal scoring opportunity there.
A little trip off a pick there, and Schreiber can't pick the far side on Hill.
Rock 0 for 2 on the peeper tonight, so they got to get going here. And maybe we see them try something different, but so far we've seen Rogers staying true at that top position there.
Dan Craig will help draw this one up.
Ready, 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 ready. righty.
Played up top again. Rogers, give and go. Wants it back. Whips it in. What a shot as Rogers scores on the power play to swing Toronto within one.
And that's why you have Chalen Rogers at the point. Being the power play specialist, the quarterback, whatever you want to call it, it's that unbelievable shot and that patented windup. He pulls back from so far. We'll see, just a little game of catch, back and forth with Manns, and he just unloads and beats Warren Hill. But Halifax has to do a much better job taking away that time and space, of course. You don't want to overextend yourself because then you open up passing lanes to Shriver or to Craig. But that's just far, far too easy for the captain, Chalen Rogers.
Fifth of the season. He had two last week against Buffalo.
I mean, John, you can start making an argument. He's one of, if not the best, all-around lacrosse player on the planet right now. He can play O, he can play D, pushes the ball in transition. I'm sure if you gave him pads, he'd go in there. He'd be pretty good at that, too.
Well, Matt Sawyer was certainly singing the same tune that you were. Just the ever-changing roster landscape with protocols and injuries. Taking a run at Toronto again, and Rogers steps up, cooling, plays a pivotal role.
Great feed there from Jameson to Jackson, but Jackson just smothered by a couple of Rock defenders. Great job collapsing, playing that collapsing D for Toronto.
Can he do it again? Nearly went back to the same spot to Rogers. This time, Hill was equal to the task. Halifax. Working it around, Peterson. Trying to go inside with it, quick release, and that's a nice goal. LeBlanc beats Rose, who shakes the head on that one for the former Toronto Rock.
And you absolutely love to see it. Steph LeBlanc has struggled to find the back of the net early on in his campaign here with the Thunderbirds. He's a former Toronto Rock. But Peterson gets that feed right to the middle. There's not much space to shoot there, and that's exactly why Halifax went out and grabbed Steph LeBlanc. It's the big body, but it's also that finish in the middle. His first goal as a T-Bird, and it's a big one here for Halifax.
It's 9 years in Toronto for LeBlanc, and right off the draw, nearly another Thunderbirds tally, but a golden opportunity nonetheless. Is shifting into a bit of a different gear here. Jenks dishes off, and Connor Watson, another newbie, something to celebrate.
John, we're gonna run out of balls here, I think. All these rookies are lighting the lamp here tonight. And that was an unbelievable rip, top corner from Watson. And it looks like we're going to actually get a goalie change here. Is speaking of firsts, Troy Holichuk going to get his first action in the National Lacrosse League. And I don't know if that's on Nick Rose, if it's maybe for him to gather himself, wake up the defense. But this is just an absolute snipe. Great feed from Shanks as he turns around here and just stinging the corner as the rookie. We'll see it here. I don't think that's a... And even a defender there might even got a stick, change the plane there, but look at Watson. He is absolutely fired up. His first NLL goal. What a special moment for the rookie.
That is a premier shot. And so Troy Holichuk from St. Catharines tending the twine now for the Rock. All of a sudden, Halifax has opened up a three-goal gap. Peterson.
Toronto getting really extended here, starting to really up the pressure defense. It works that time as Halifax not very many shooting options, but wait to see if Halifax can start to expose the middle of the floor as things start to really open up.
Weir did a nice job to move that one over to Dawson in a hurry. Craig looking for an opening. rebound on the far side with the captain, but Toronto will depart and change things up in transition. Armstrong. That one off the bar. Not sure if Polichuk saw all of that or if he's just trying to get into the game. Halifax isn't going to get many breaks. Especially when Austin Shanks has it. It crumpled into the end boards. A little earful there on the way by. The official, Rogers, a bouncer. That one popped up something else in front. Lots of room for Halifax to move this up. Big challenge for the Thunderbirds, as we mentioned, with the time off, Pat, and the refrain we kept hearing was, well, these guys, we don't want their conditioning to be an excuse.
That's certainly the case, not the case here today. We'll see maybe if that comes down the stretch, but something that they will continue that after this break here.
Mazuka dished it off to Snow. Was hoping to help out Mazuka. Nifty play at the side. LeBlanc looking for his second of the night.
Yeah, LeBlanc looking much more comfortable in this offense, really starting to find his stride. And I think a big reason is Cody Jamison coming back to line. Now a lot of attention is to number 88, so it frees up a little more space for him.
Play off the pick, opened up a nice avenue, and Hill stood firm in that net. Armstrong all alone shoots. There's a big stop by Holichuk.
Troy Holichuk up to the task early on so far. The youngster, he was so young this past summer, was able to play junior A lacrosse for the Six Nations Arrows.
Rock Colt Armstrong on that last opportunity, and he says, I can do that too, shut the door. Armstrong again picks up a loose ball. Halifax contesting this. Manns will get back to support, however. Find the handle. Craig will take his time. Bring up top and nearly skipped that one past Hill. Cockerton wanted to swing it all the way back. Didn't work out for him, though. Instead, Halifax will piggyback on the ball moving up the floor.
Yeah, smart move by Thompson to slow things down. Don't push it unless you have an option there, which he clearly did not.
Trying to hurry up. Kyle Jackson put himself in position. Just no movement.
Adam Jay going to get a penalty there as he knocked Kyle Jackson.
Halifax has opened it up again, and they have doubled up Toronto on the board, 6-3. City of Hamilton is situated upon the traditional territories of the Erie, neutral. Here on Wendat, Haudenosaunee, and Mississaugas. It's covered by the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Belt Covenant, which was an agreement between the Haudenosaunee and Anishinaabe to share and care for the resources around the Great Lakes. We further acknowledge that this land is covered by the Between the Lakes Purchase of 1792. Today, Hamilton, home to many indigenous people from across Turtle Island, we recognize that we must do more to learn about the rich history of this land so we can better understand our roles as residents, neighbors, partners, and caretakers. And it is a power play for the Thunderbirds. Try to open things up a little further here in the second quarter.
Great block by Mitch Desnew there. Absolutely soaking the shot from Chase.
Peterson lets it fly. Wide to Holochuk, who's now in goal, replacing Rose.
So it's going to be over and back, much like you see in basketball. So the Rock are going to take possession here. 30 seconds to chew up as much clock as possible. But down by three goals, if they get a chance here, John, they'll take it.
They have some personnel on the floor that's certainly able to make something happen. But you're right, clock killing for a moment.
Tyson Bell against Challen Rogers, a pretty good matchup I would not mind seeing.
Oh, the twig comes loose. And Rogers inside track, trying to make something happen, but the ball bobbling.
Yeah, and I think that was a trail check from Graham Hossick, who every time he steps on the turf, just gets better and better. In my personal opinion, the best defender in the game, one of the best all-around players in the game. He's so much fun to watch.
Referred to as Cyborg, and as Halifax works the inside, it's stopped by Holochuk, who settled in after a post on the second shot from Halifax. Yeah, not hard to miss Hossick.
No.
Out on the floor. My goodness, what a beast. Peterson dished it off. Chance was going for another opportunity, but Halifax changes. Toronto trying to work their way back on the board. Really able to use the second quarter to their favor in Buffalo a week ago, and it actually became a tale of quarters in that game.
Yes, but it did.
We spoke with Matt Sawyer earlier. One of the problems when you don't have that first quarter lead to work with, boy, it's tough to chase the game, even tougher if you get away from your game, and sometimes that's been the case.
And it's the finer details that is really that Matt Sawyer seems to think that it's gone away from this team. And that's something that they try to fine-tune in practice. It's fundamentals, it's boring, but it's so important.
Bucci spreads it out. Peterson had a good look. Craig blocked it, steals it, starts it up. Craig for a run. And Hill somehow keeps that one out.
I know Craig's been the best lefty so far here tonight, but when he gets caught on defense, becomes quite the transition option. That's twice now he's started a goal-scoring opportunity from his own end.
A hard shot delivered by Watson. He has one. He wants another one.
Yeah, Halifax really getting sloppy here with their shots. Just throwing everything lately. Feels like they haven't hit the net in a while.
Watson finds another one. So it's two in his debut for Connor Watson.
Watson, what a story it's been for him tonight. Getting into the lineup due to a couple of injuries. And he has made the most of his time here. What a great pick there before. Nice fake, goes through the legs. And again, Austin Shanks, another point. And look at the rookie, watch, finishes. Are you not entertained? The youngster's got some swagger to him.
Made it look easy. And the latest of two in a row. So he has picked up the ball and ran with it quite literally for Halifax here. Burns, a three consecutive goal run for the Thunderbirds, now up by four. Toronto trying to turn the tide a little bit. And they do! A surprise corner picked by Jameson Dilks.
He's not a rookie, but that's his first goal, and it's special for him considering he grew up right here in the Hammer. Hamilton, Ontario native. Dilks just unloading a shot. That's one that Hill's probably going to walk back. He looked to sweep that stick in between the five hole, but Dilks certainly fired up with that, and it looks like we got a challenge flag here, as I think Mike Kersey thinks one of the Rock players might have ran through the crease before that ball went in.
Well, we'll do our best to put our sources on it. Be cruel punishment for Dilks to have that one come back.
Oh, I know. And unfortunately, no family, friends in the building here tonight, but you certainly know for sure the family, the Dilks, will be watching at home on TSN here. Papa Dilks, especially, one of the most electric follows on Twitter.
We're happy to have everybody on board tonight, although we do hope fans can get back in the building soon enough.
So we're going to see here the top of the screen. So Dilks, as he unloads that, we'll see. I think this is going to be the best look here. Schreiber walks through, and he realizes he runs out of space. It's just when he jumps, is that foot on the crease? As you see, the officials taking a hard
look. I almost need another look at it, but it seemed like in real time it might have been okay.
I think it's okay, but it would be great if we could get an overhead view. So the crease is cut off on the overhead, so that's not going to help us out at all. As he jumps up, and the ball is already in the net when he lands back, and we can't even see if, when the ball does go in the net, does he land?
It's almost like a sideline catcher, two feet in football.
I'm gonna guess
there's
here,
green there.
I think it's got to be a goal, and even if it's not, there's not enough conclusive evidence to turn that over. It's going to stay. It looks like the only other thing is if we could see where Schreiber lands, but I believe when he lands anyways, that ball's in the back of the net.
Get all the breaking NLL news, updates, stories, and more right in your inbox. Sign up for the NLL newsletter today by going to NLL.com. Been a great week again around the league.
Yes.
Phenomenal games. Lots of action. We're joking and being amazed at what the Seals were doing.
Unbelievable. Back-to-back games with rookie goaltenders getting their first starts. And last night, Justin Getty, the latest of them, just a 20-year-old netminder. They signed him earlier on the week, had some COVID protocol issues with both their goalies. He goes in, and he was tremendous, and he was going up against a potent offense in the Saskatchewan Rush. Unbelievable. A lot of talk, John, when people talk about expansion in the National Lacrosse League, adding more teams. The big question mark is there enough quality goaltending? And I'll be honest, I was kind of leaning that there wasn't, but this year it's proving we see so many great young goalies. Troy Holichuk, a perfect example.
Due to inconclusive evidence, we got a good goal.
And there would be mass cheering. But I'm guessing in a living room somewhere there is for Jameson Dilks. So that one stands, and first goal from the Hamilton boy in the Hammer. As you said, that's a special moment
in his career. That'd be pretty awkward if they'd have to throw the ball back. And it doesn't count, but it will count. It will stand. First career goal for Dilks.
Toronto just trying to creep back in this one. Stop the Halifax floodgate for now. Bushi got some room. Shoots. Good stop there by Holichuk following that play. It has been largely Halifax until a Toronto stopper. Jameson Dilks, his first in the NLL. I want to remind you to stay tuned for the Guaranteed Rate Halftime Report. Ashley will be along and wrangle one of the players for an interview. Pat and I will break down the first half action. We'll take a look at the life outside of lacrosse for many of these athletes in the game today. There's the family responsibilities, but there's the 9-to-5 job too. Most of them are fitting in the practices and then preparing in their own time for the games in this league.
Unique lifestyle of an NLLer.
Makes it even more impressive.
Yeah.
With the skill in the league, and the execution, and the commitment. Most exciting league going. These guys are committed to keeping it that way. Love it. Hands. Couple of shimmy shakes now. He drives. Everybody scores. Zach Mans, the man.
Massive goal for Toronto here to chip away at this Halifax lead, but a huge goal for Mans for his confidence. Struggled this year in and out of the lineup. His first goal of the season, and it's an absolute beauty. Dives across the crease. But he has the wherewithal to bring it across his body, right over the shoulder of Warren Hill. And it's also Withers. And look at Dan Dawson, the veteran fired up for the youngster. Are you kidding me, man? Are you kidding me with that goal? But I was going to say, Jake Withers there, that's the guy he sliced and diced. No slouch there.
Yeah, that's not an everyday highlight. You find Withers on the other end, you're right. Talked in the opening about the two-punch of Hossack and Withers, but Mans just sliced right through. What a finish, and we might have a little bit more coming up here as the game gets closer to half. Want to take a break just yet. Noble on the bottom.
That's Kyle Jackson on the top. John, I'll be honest, I was looking up the other way, didn't see what happened.
It was, I don't believe there was any extra shot in there, but quickly.
Clean battle here, and then it's Noble who grabs him, and Jackson with a couple of healthy shots on the top. Jackson not known
for throwing knocks. It's those silky myths that he's known for setting up beautiful plays, but Noble, not only is he a tremendous defender, he is a guy that gets under your skin. He is so annoying to play against. You hate to play against him, but you absolutely love to have him on your side.
Those guys are so key, it seems, in any league, in any room. Jackson perhaps no different. But he'll pick up the extra two, I believe.
Yes.
Which makes sense. So that sends Toronto to another window of opportunity before the half here.
Yeah, the in-home Ryan Tarasenko is going to serve it, so it will be 5-on-4. Mike Kersey not pleased with Jackson for taking that extra one there. So the power play that's struggled, just 1-for-3 so far tonight. We'll see if they can get it going again.
Mans bounces that one through.
Tarasenko, as I mentioned, he's serving Jackson's additional penalty, so that's why it's 5-on-4, not 4-on-4, for the extra 2 minutes tacked on.
Halifax just trying to eat some clock here. Bushi trying to allow the play to push forward. Shot clock expires and Toronto get this back. About 1:05 to go on the power play. Craig motioning over. Rogers, will he shoot behind the back, sets it up. What a finish from Schreiber! And a nice feed from Rogers, and The Rock used the power play to get back on the board.
Goal number 9 on the season for Schreiber. And it should come as no surprise. It comes on the power play. The man they call Captain America gets that little behind the back feed from Challen Rogers. And again, just too much time and space for these shooters for The Rock. Mungo Thompson does get up to challenge it, but it's just a bit too late. We'll see the rotation come up. And that's just a great shot from a great player and a new dad as well.
We know who that one's going out to for sure. Congrats again to the Schreiber household. And a power play goal. Climbs right back into within one all of a sudden. And can't ignore the man at this end, Pat.
Absolutely, Troy Holchuk, since he's come in, just 1 goal against. He has really calmed down this defense and has allowed Toronto to get back into this game. And that's one thing that Matt Sawyer, the head coach of the Toronto Raptors, said. They have gone down early, but they've had that counterpunch. They've always been able to come back in the game. We'll see if they can finally take a lead here, though.
Speaking of counterpunch, that was Hossek using the big frame to turn it around for the Thunderbirds as they jam the net and come up with a pretty one as well. As Fennell tucks it in over Holichuk.
Boy, I am mush. I can't believe I just jinxed the young netminder as Fennell gets his second goal this season. But how about this battle? Loose ball comes through, and it's Ryan Tarasenko, the former Buckeye of Ohio State, gets that pass right across to another Buckeye. The Ohio State connection is real here for the Thunderbirds. As Fennell comes across, a little fake, boom, right in the back of the net. Tarasenko, his first NLL point. He's certainly going to be fired up bringing that ball home across the border for the American, the Sinking Spring, Pennsylvania native.
Didn't realize that Fennell played goalie so late into his career.
Yes, it's quite impressive.
Like, that's not a story you hear very often.
Absolutely not. We've seen some goalies turn into defenders, but you know, he started as a goaltender, played in junior A lacrosse, and then decided he's going to play a little out. Scholarship to The Ohio State University and now playing in the National Lacrosse League. Remarkable stuff. But Jake Withers also plays for the Buckeyes, or played for the Buckeyes. Austin Shanks as well, so a lot of Ohio State connection here for Halifax.
And Shanks had the latest one to be denied by Holichuk. 9 seconds of second quarter leading into the half. And a little miscommunication there. And that leads to a timeout.
Yeah, Toronto is going to take a timeout here, try to chalk something up. We'll have 24.2 seconds left.
Give us a chance to keep you up to speed with the NFL Super Wildcard weekend continuing tomorrow. Triple header action. The Eagles against the reigning champ Bucks, 49ers and Cowboys. Love that matchup. And the Steelers taking on the Chiefs in a Sunday night showdown. Coverage kicks off at 1 Eastern, 10 Pacific on CTV and TSN. Park yourself in the chair, Patty, and enjoy some football.
I was going to say, bad day to be a coach tomorrow. Mom, if you're watching, no chores tomorrow. No dishes, nothing.
And meatloaf, Mom. Don't forget the meatloaf. Yeah, it has been fun to keep up with that league, but we got ourselves a lacrosse game as the Rock have clawed their way back in. Now, this was a little bit of a familiar story in Buffalo a week ago. As they got close, they really liked, I think, their second quarter heading into the half, and then the Bandits seemed to be able to separate. So this will be something the Rock don't want to have as familiar territory. We'll see the response in the final 20 some odd seconds, what they drew up here, Pat, and then of course flipping it to the other side of the half as well.
Yeah, this would be absolutely massive if you can cut that lead just to one goal going into the second half. Of course, if you don't score here, no need to hit the panic button. Like you said, a two-goal lead here, but it would be an absolute bolster to the confidence here for Toronto's offense to really start to get clicking.
Vance. Bill shuts the door on Craig. There goes Holichuk. He just needs to get to the bench a bit quicker. That's a long sprint for the big man. Now the extra tacker on for Toronto as they go all in. And Hill at the post as the buzzer sounds denies that. But I like the aggressiveness.
Absolutely. And Schreiber there, obviously, you're not going to knock him for taking the shot. But you saw that open man in the middle. Mark Cochran maybe could have got that shot in the middle and put it in the back of the net.
Been an entertaining start to the NLL game of the week. Shanks has been a big part of it for Halifax, but some newcomers getting their first goals as well. And Toronto picked it up at the end of the second quarter to cut the gap to 2. The Guaranteed Rate halftime report is coming up. Good first half in the books from Hamilton on the NLL game of the week on TSN.
Up to date, I think.
Easy with the angles, okay. Buddy.
Right.
Double chin.
Hey, one of these.
Okay, sounds good. Okay, 3, 2. Austin Shanks, you foreshadowed that we'd be having this discussion today, amped to get back onto the field. Before this game, did the coaches talk to you a little bit about you having the green light or what they expected from you in your return?
I think Kirsiaz is trusting me and Stu Mungus. They just said, let the game come to me, and I felt like I did. We're moving the ball's going in, and we're just having fun out there.
Talk to me quickly about Watson. You've assisted on both of his goals. What do you like from the young guy?
I loved him in training camp, actually. I really liked playing with him. I was so excited he got his shot out here, and I wanted to assist his first one, so I was pumped I could. The kid's good. He's young. The roof's the limit for that guy. Like, he's so good. He's so young. So much to learn, and he's playing like a vet out here. I love having him out there.
Get a mullet shake?
I'm going to get him one. I'll get Watson to get mullet.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the NLL Game of the Week and the Guaranteed Rate Halftime Report from Hamilton, Ontario. Toronto Rock making some good progress in the second quarter, working their way back on the scoreboard, but still trail the Halifax Thunderbirds 8-6 after two quarters. Standing by with one of the stars from the Thunderbirds is our own Ashley Docking.
Shanks, you foreshadowed that we'd be having this discussion today, amped to get back onto the field. Before this game, did the coaches talk to you a little bit about you having the green light or what they expected from you in your return?
I think Kirsiaz is trusting me and Stu Mungus. They just said, let the game come to me, and I felt like I did. We're moving the ball's going in, and we're just having fun out there.
Talk to me quickly about Watson. You've assisted on both of his goals. What do you like from the young guy?
I loved him in training camp, actually. I really liked playing with him. I was so excited he got his shot out here, and I wanted to assist his first one, so I was pumped I could. The kid's good. He's young. The roof's the limit for that guy. Like, he's so good. He's so young. So much to learn, and he's playing like a vet out here. I love having him out there.
Let's get a mullet shake?
I'm going to get him one. I'll get Watson to get mullet.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Well, I wish I could do that, but clean cut all the way around, so we'll leave it to Austin Shanks. And, Pat, we were keeping our eyes on Dan Dawson. We still will be, and not only his 300th game, but where he sits in some historical point records. But our focus shifted to Austin Shanks pretty quickly and how he fit in so quickly to the Halifax offense.
Absolutely, and we talked about how Cody Jamieson, the captain, was coming into the fold here. And for him, he's been okay. He hasn't got his looks, but it's an all Austin Shanks all the time. He said it in that interview with Ashley. They're just having fun right now, shooting the lights out. 5 points for him. He has been electric, and this was the best goal, the quick stick off the boards. You can just tell he's playing with some swagger. I mentioned he struggled with some injuries. It's great to see him healthy. Dan Dawson, though, hunting for that elusive 2 points so he can pass John Grant Jr. But the Halifax Thunderbirds have done a great job teeing him up. Luke Magnan loses his stick here, but still, great job able to put some pressure on here. Dawson, again, we know he's going to get it eventually. Is it going to come tonight? Warren Hill saying no as he makes a big stop there. But how about Dan Craig tonight? Getting involved on the other end. Again, pushed it here, but now we're going to see Zach Mans. Probably the nicest goal we've seen here tonight. Crease dive, crippler, finish, the twister, an unbelievable goal from an unbelievable player. A guy that's struggled to find his groove early on. We talked about it before this game. He's a guy that had a lot of pressure on himself. And he's now coming into the fold, playing some great lacrosse, and they need it here.
See the numbers tilting in favor of Toronto, but not on the scoreboard at the end of it. Plenty of first-timers getting into the action as well. Chris Weir, Jamieson Dilks with their first NLL goals, and you already mentioned it, Connor Watson as well on the other side for Halifax. So it's been an all-around really fun first half of lacrosse, and we will continue with our Guaranteed Rate Halftime Report from Hamilton. We come back on the NLL Game of the Week. Take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard presented by Sports Interaction. Buffalo wins again. They come back to stun Georgia. San Diego, they keep the rookies rolling. And Equin out against Saskatchewan. Albany beats Philadelphia, which might help both teams in attendance in our NLL game of the week, perhaps in the standings. And Panther City, New York, still going on as we speak. As we continue with the Guaranteed Rate Halftime Report, it's time now to join Ashley Docking.
John, there is a real argument to be made that NLL players are the most dedicated pro athletes around. They train, they watch tape, they travel, and oh yeah, a number of them hold down full-time jobs as well and have families that require love and attention. Senior producer and NLL reporter Devin Caney sat down with some of our stars to talk about how they strike a balance.
Shot on goal, score!
Firefighters, cops, there's finance guys.
Police officers, teachers, some accountants.
Labor guys, there's construction guys, there's literally all walks of life.
What's something that makes the NLL unique versus other sports like the NBA, like NFL?
I think it's the fact that we're still coming out here and we still have second jobs. It's like the transitioning part to be a professional athlete after working is pretty cool.
Friday, guys are flying out. Saturday, they're playing. Sunday, they're going right back home. Monday, they're right back into the office.
My job is I sell research robotic platforms. It is quite the jump from playing lacrosse on weekends to having some in-depth technical conversations Monday to Friday.
I'm a high school phys ed and science teacher. I coach the hockey and lacrosse team there. A lot of the kids actually can come to the game. So they say, you know, Mr. Vince, I'm going to be at the game on Saturday. Throw me a lacrosse ball or something like that. And then it doesn't stop when I go home. And then I got the two kids running around as well.
I give a lot of respect for those people that have full-time jobs or part-time jobs and then also families as well. And then to stay in shape and practice or go away for games.
It's early mornings. It's getting the kids off to school and then starting my, you know, 9 to 5. Then after the kids go to bed, having to watch tape on the upcoming team and then fitting in trainings.
Dawson, double team, shoots, scores!
Work for the City of Brampton Fire Department.
And you work with your brother, Paul?
Yep, he's in the same fire department. He's 4 years behind me, and we're on different shifts, different stations, but we work for the same fire department.
You usually work about 2 days a week for 24 hours. It's a very physical job. They're actually encouraged to work out at the hall, so we get an hour a day. So the same thing kind of goes with lacrosse. We're trying to accomplish a goal of winning a championship or winning a game, but there's goals, there's rules, there's things we need to do to accomplish that. So I get to bring what I learned from firefighting into my team, which is kind of cool.
When you're on the truck with four other members of the fire department, you can't have off days. Like, you have to hold your weight, not only on an emergency call or whatever it is.
Here's a chance to retrieve a great trail check from Baptiste.
We do it for the love of the game. It's impressive what we can put out on the floor, having, you know, other focuses in life.
You don't know where your week began and ended because it's just such a rush.
There's not a single guy in our league who wakes up on Saturday morning, he's like, oh, I've got to go through this again. We get to be here in the NLL, it's pretty special.
That's why so many of us play for so long, because we don't want that to end. So might as well take advantage of it now.
Great look into the NLL. Great look at this goal, the halftime report. Welcome back to the NLL Game of the Week on TSN. John Abbott, Pat Gregoire, and Ashley Dawkins getting set for the second half. Alterna Cup matchup, of course, of the two Canadian teams meeting. And it's been a healthy diet for the Halifax Thunderbirds, as this is their third game and third Canadian head-to-head. And they have the best percentage right now, along with Calgary.
Yeah, if they win here, a perfect 3-0. Toronto looking to get their first win against the Canadian Club. The Alterna Cup, it's not the NLL Cup, it's not the ultimate prize, but there's certainly a little added rivalry.
Oh, there's bragging,
here.
Right?
Absolutely.
There's patriotism. There's a hard hit that the Thunderbirds don't like right off the faceoff to start the second half. Rock, a little jump in their step here. High hit shrugged off by Craig. Held that down in time to stop Vance. He's a different player since that goal went in. And what a beautiful finish it was for Vance in that first half. Pat, you mentioned confidence. I think you see that right now with Zach Vance.
Absolutely, and he's a confident player. He likes to, you know, play with that confidence, and he's certainly doing it here tonight because he did struggle. Just 2 assists coming into this game.
Time ticking down, so they have to force it. Bouchy did. Off the back glass, get another crack, and that'll be whistled down ahead of Olichuk making a good stop.
Yeah, shot was off, but not quite in time before the shot clock expired.
Another flying bit. Hill didn't bite. From Shriver.
That's twice now. Withers getting burned pretty clean. Something we don't see often. You mentioned it. He's a tremendous defender. Everyone talks about how good at a face-off a player he is, but he's really one of the most underrated D-men in the league.
Nice read there and a steal. Strong just read the mail. That was Dilks on Jameson, and what a sliding right leg save that was.
Stop, but even better loose ball by the Rock to get that second possession. We'll see what they can do here.
Scooped up by Hill. I thought about peppering it up. Let someone else do the running though. Bell dished it off. Thunderbirds change behind the ball carrier. Bouchy. Sent over that one off the pipe. To the right of Olichuk.
That went off a shoulder and a pipe. That was an absolute rocket from the wall.
Good hit there on Brock, who already dropped the gloves in this game. LeBlanc working it in. Take the shot, dished it over. Surprised his own teammate with the height of that ball. Block has it back at the side and stopped by Holichuk to shut down the real estate real quick.
You know, John, I've been very impressed with Holichuk. He's been steady. Well, does not look like he's a rookie right now. And I said it, there are some great young goaltenders in this league.
Driver. Over to Mans. Now Rogers. Dawson wants to go. And a bouncer. Off the boards for Schreiber. Fires it on, and he'll squeeze his tight.
And that's just perfect defense by Luke Magnan. Got a little help from Colton Watkinson as well on the slide.
And a quick up, unchartered for Hossack a little bit, but he bulldozed his way right to the front.
It's a rough ball.
Great. Good pace to this second half thus far. Dawson some room. Can he make a move? He does, but denied by Hill. Toronto taking their time with a fresh 30 on the board. Hill makes it look so easy. Right for big man.
He moves well. He passes the ball real well. Although Bouchy bobbled that ball. Great job by Rogers. There you go. The guy who's just always around the ball forces that turnover.
Rock will converge as a result. And that one
slid wide by Ostrouser. Ostrouser again, trying to fight through the hacks and whacks along the way.
Again, another extended possession here from the Rock. We'll see if they can finally capitalize.
That looked like a nice telegraph play from Dawson. You could see where he wanted to go with it.
Just unfortunately, I think Rogers thought there should have been a holding the stick there as Tarasenko maybe got a little bit of aluminum in his paw there, but no call, no harm, no foul.
Back into the middle, Bucci couldn't handle it. Bucci, what a goal! Off the backboard and a bury from Bucci.
It's bad in Bucci. And it's a rebound off the backboard. A little bit different from Shanks, but just as pretty as Bucci gets goal number two on the evening. We'll see the replay right here. Peterson, little toe drag, takes the shot. That one goes wide. And Bucci, great job to keep his feet out of the crease. One more time here. As we'll see, Bucci bats that out of the air. That's not even really a quick stick. That is almost like a one-timer in and out of the stick so quick. Bucci showing off his athleticism there. The pride of Queen's University in Kingston. One of the many Kufla lacrosse players here. A lot of NCAA talent, but there's some good ball up north here at the collegiate level, John.
Burlington Chiefs grad as well.
Halifax penalty, 2 minutes, that's for slight conduct.
And Thunderbirds go to the box after they capitalize, but I want another look at what transpired. Bucci with some magic at the side. Increases the Thunderbirds lead.
Thunderbirds in the box as we bring you back to Hamilton.
And Jake Withers is going to sit down for two. He gets the face-off infraction here, and he's going to have a couple of extra words for the official here. And this is when you say, all right, Jake, that's enough. Sit down for two, unsportsmanlike. It's been a frustrating night for Jake Withers. 9-9 between him and TD Erland. So Erland giving him some fits. I mentioned a couple of times he got exposed defensively. A very uncharacteristic night for Withers. We'll see if he can bounce back after he gets out of the sin bin.
Rock will try to do what they've done in this game in the middle chunk of it anyway. That's put some goals together to work their way back on the board. Rogers, a couple of looks. Shriver up top. At the side, what a snipe! My goodness! Craig puts that where only a ball could fit.
Have a night, Dan Craig. We said someone on the left-hand side of the floor has to step up. And it's the Penn State Nittany Lion doing his job here tonight. Oh, almost identical goal
on the man advantage here. We'll see, get back down to Craig. Craig's going to get it. Skip pass. Shriver gets it back to Rogers. Rogers, little skip to the crease. Quick stick, bang. Right in the back of the net. Challen Rogers, my oh my. I don't want to take away from the play of Dan Craig here, but what we're seeing from Challen Rogers the past month, it's remarkable. He has been unbelievable. He can do everything.
Well, let's expand that with Ashley Docking.
Yeah, Challen Rogers is asked to do a lot for this team. Dan Dawson said he calls him weapon and says the sky is the limit for the young guy, but he needs to play a little bit meaner. I talked to Rogers about being too nice. He said it's something that he's been told since he was in minor. Always smiling, coaches telling him, put it away. Be a little bit meaner, he said. I don't really know how I'm going to do it. Maybe listen to some death metal or dubstep pregame, he joked. But he said he's focusing on playing physical, worrying about what he can control.
Thanks, Ashley. I told Pat the same thing, but he's not shaking it up. Always in a great mood. We love it. Bringing the energy, and it's easy to these two teams tonight.
And that's a huge, huge defensive shift. Get that 30-second clock and keep that momentum from that power play goal. And the power play really starting to cook here for Toronto, 3-for-5. If you're Halifax, you absolutely need to stay out of the box.
Dawson, Craig, right off the bucket, it sounded like, of Hill. They sprint back up, Craig wants it back. Trying to get that one away from Brock, who hangs in there. Armstrong, take a look.
I've been very critical of these lefties all week long, saying they just need to be better. And boy, they certainly have, especially Dan Craig. He's been electric tonight.
Jameson, watching as Bushy. Trying to make it two in a row in the third quarter. Denied by Holichuk. A surprise pass there for Oosthuizen. Might have been paying attention to contact that was about to come up and grab him. Boy, a lot of loose sticks on the floor tonight.
Good job by Lee. Good job by LeBlanc to get back on defense. Great back check. And caused Jubinville to take that shot to bounce a little bit too early than where he wanted it to go.
Yeah, the look off didn't work for Jubinville. Loose ball scoop.
A couple of really sloppy shifts offensively for Halifax. They got to clean this up.
Looks a transition. Scores! Second for Jameson Dilts. That one was pretty. And it's a no-doubter this time from the Hamilton kid.
Yeah, I'm not too sure when the next election is here in Hammer. But Dilts should be tossing his hat in the ring here for the mayor of Hamilton. Because the hometown boy has been unbelievable here tonight. Known as a stay-at-home defender, he's getting in on the scoring, his second of the night. And again, it's that awkward release that he has, ends up working in his favor as that one just beats Warren Hill and get this one back to a one-goal game.
I like this plays in Toronto's favor. Obviously the goal does, but so far, the third quarter.
No doubt, and this is going to be a big, big response here from Halifax. What can they do? They haven't faced much adversity in this game. Are they going to be able to close the gap once again here? Or extend the gap, I should say. Or is it going to be Toronto who's going to close the gap and tie this game up? Very sloppy play. You can tell Mike Kersey fuming right now. Wants his offense to get back to playing the way that they can. Play fast, but play controlled.
Off the pipe. Right back into play for Halifax. Trying to go low this time, and Holichuk read all of that one. Like those orange jerseys you see in Halifax? You could bid on those if you like any of the other game day league paraphernalia. You can shop your favorite teams, jerseys, and merchandises as well. Head to fanatics.ca to get all your National Lacrosse League and team gear today. Now there's some sharp unis, sharp logos around the league.
tension starting to build a little bit between these two Canadian rivals.
It's going to be over and back. See maybe if Halifax elects to use the full 30 seconds here, calm things down, try to get some momentum back on their side.
Quick set, they go across, back to Bushi. What a stop there by Holochuk. He held his ground and denied Bushi, who's really upped his game here. Rogers, little spin back.
Haven't seen Cody Jamison in a couple of shifts. He's still on the bench there. Just
in touch, they score. Mans again. And he's got it to a tie for Toronto.
Mans, oh man. What a night it's been for the second year Toronto Rock player. Rogers again. This guy is ridiculous. Gets that pass over to Craig. Craig finds Mans, who's all alone. That's just unacceptable defense. They're just getting caught up here. Withers gets caught ball watching. And another defender in the middle will probably see right here. That's Graham Hossack. He doesn't get exposed all too often. But Mans, he's a guy we talked about. I had some high expectations for him coming into this season. A slow start, but nothing has been slow about Mans' play here tonight. Goal number two for him. We're tied 9-9.
Victoria BC boy making his presence felt.
A good Victoria boy, as they like to say.
And this is something Toronto couldn't do last week, and that is fight their way back in. Instead, they fought at the end to put the curtains on the loss to the Bandits. And impressive showing from The Rock.
And a big reason has been the play of the young netminder, Troy Holochuk, who's their third string goalie. Keep that in mind.
Weir, who has his first NLL goal in his back pocket tonight, hands off for Dawson. He's got a few. Dawson, a little behind the back. Shriver in the middle. And Hill takes that one away from Cockerton. Haven't said his name a whole lot tonight, but he's getting used to the flow of things.
That's another costly turnover by Thompson. He has struggled to transition the ball safely here tonight.
Well, that was a nice move, pull move by Rogers. I don't know if that was the intended result, though, at the end of it. Nonetheless, Toronto still with possession. Rogers had the head down. Time ticking down on the clock. Walker going to want to let this one go. And they do, ripping it wide. Trying to scoop and dive and score. Unsuccessful that time around. Dan Dawson. It's his night, and The Rock have drawn even. Tonight's turning point is presented by Fanatics.ca, and the Rock have turned it around, Pat.
3 goals in just over 4 minutes, 4 minutes and 12 seconds to be exact, but it's been all different types of goals. We saw the power play, Dilks gets a second in transition, and this one just an ugly defensive mishap here, but Mans is going to take advantage of that, scores his second goal of the game, and we talked about it. This Rock team has always had the reply. They've always... The thing that Dan Dawson said to myself and Ashley Dockin earlier this week, they haven't been out-hustled, or they haven't been out-worked hard. They've been out... he said they've been out, not worked, but executed, out-executed. And that's something that they're doing tonight, is they're executing.
And more on point, to be certain. High off the glass, and it's right in the scoop for Desnoux. He's going to go for a run with it. Look at the defensive side come up with Sheldon Burns getting a shot away.
Find it! Good battle here in the corner. Desnoux and Rock, and again, Tarasenko having himself a pretty fine first NLL game. You see the athleticism.
It's Ryan Tarasenko, who you're alluding to. Rock trying to play some tight D here. LeBlanc couldn't work his way on the outside, and Toronto trying to take advantage. And Hill on the quick up will stop that one on the side. Bell with lots of room in front of him, dishes over. High flying finish, and that is in behind Holichuk. Bushy again.
Chris Bushy, 3 goals for him. And this one is absolutely gorgeous. Another crease dive. We know Bushy's a sharpshooter, but he's showing off his athleticism here tonight. Another crease dive for him. Gets that off, and little twister finish at the end. Tyson Bell doing a great job getting in transition. Brad Cree probably, okay, he drops the stick. I was just going to say, should play the body there, but it's his stick that breaks as he throws that cross check. And Bushy, again, another righty, getting involved here in the scoring once again.
Bushy and Shanks have really lit it up for Halifax, and a 1-goal gap again on the board for the Thunderbirds. Nearing the end of the third, Hill extends to take that one away from Schreiber.
Just 3 games in the season, and Bushy's already exceeded all his offensive stats from last year. And it's remarkable the confidence this guy has in his game. Dawson isolated here with Bell.
Well, it tells you something when Peterson, who had 6 the last time these teams met, hasn't been as dynamic. He's helped out. Jameson in and out tonight, but it didn't have to be the story so far.
Toronto getting back to their old ways, which you would think is a bad thing. They play that isolation ball, and it doesn't always work, but so far here tonight, it has worked. Warren Hill's just come out to the task and made a couple of big stops there, and we're going to get a delayed penalty. I think Clark Peterson got a healthy little hack on his knee there.
Minnell to LeBlanc, and up top, Jameson. Close in with the extra attacker on. LeBlanc shoots, and pushing over to his right to make the stop is Holichuk, but the Rock to the box.
Sheldon Burns going to head off here, the pride of Whitby, Ontario, another Whitby Warrior. Mentioned that great historic junior franchise. Well, Burns shaking his head in disbelief. He missed a couple of games at the start of the season, but he's a guy that, it's crazy to think he's been in the league for a long time. He's now a veteran on this team, and he certainly helps the calming presence back there.
So look at Rock coach Matt Sawyer. I know he was alluding to that with you as well, Pat, but just as they worked so hard to get back onto the scoreboard and tie the game, then a mistake, then a penalty, and they're trying to stem the tide here.
And and eliminate those mistakes. Very similar to Steph LeBlanc there, just missing an easy ball up in the air. It goes over and back. Now
with 33 seconds left in the quarter, the Rock have a lot of time to chew up this power play.
Working on the outside. A crazy bounce out of the corner. Halifax will have time before the quarter's up.
10 seconds here, so not a lot of time. Got to do something here.
Bell spreads it out, might want it back. Jamieson dishing off. Lately it's been Bushy's number. Toronto protects in front. And that'll do it for the third quarter. As the Rock worked all the way back on the board, but the Thunderbirds found that extra tally before the end of it. Really entertaining NLL game of the week, and it keeps getting better the closer the score becomes. We'll take you to a one-goal game headed to the fourth after this. South Africa's own Chris Bushy has three tonight. He's running red hot, Ashley Docking.
He's really come alive this season for Halifax, John, and one of the reasons is confidence. Head coach Micah Kersey says Bushy was really letting his belief and his abilities be dictated by his most recent performance. So it was game to game, super high, super low. He says he's now realized that he can go 0-0-0 on the stat line and still make an impact. For his part, Bushy says, I was really trying to emulate my game after players that I respected or looked up to, but now I'm focused on the player that I am, not the player I'm not, John.
Thanks, Ashley. Great insight, and pretty cool to have roots to Joburg.
Yeah, he started the South African national team, which is awesome to see the game grow all across the world. Easy face-off win by Jake Withers, which is something I normally say when calling a Halifax game, but tonight TD Erland's been giving him a ton of fits. It's been almost even.
Halifax working on the back end of a power play to start this final quarter.
Look to see Cody Jamieson get a little more involved here on this power play.
Heavy shot off the end boards, bouncing it up. I think Holichuk got a piece of that. Trying to crash and bang his Fennell, doesn't work. Rock have taken it back. Swap flies with that left hand. Come all the way up the floor.
Great back check there by Bushy. Yeah,
the snoo just kept the motor going.
15 seconds here in the power play, so they got to be aware. Sheldon Burns popping out of the penalty box here. Be aware of the time.
Austin Shanks dished it over. Jamieson lets it fly. Rock out of penalty trouble. See if they can tie it again. Burns out of the box so they can change their alignment. Cockerton be traffic. Mans couldn't handle it. Going to go stride for stride now. Keep the Thunderbirds at bay for a moment. Bell spots a man in tight. He coughs it up, though. Both teams have been uncharacteristic in some turnovers.
Yeah, Halifax, especially that last quarter, just throwing the ball all over the yard. You can guarantee that Michael Curzon told his team, settle things down. Let's not force the issue here. Toronto wants it to be a track meet. Let's play transition, not track meet. That's something he tells his defense all the time.
Armstrong, he has difficulties with it. There's a loose ball scoop. Rock pick it up on the fly. Craig helped himself to it. Mazzucca.
Defensive coordinator Billy D. Smith having a word with his defense right now. You can guarantee he's saying, let's control the ball here. Let's not force things, fellas.
Mans was going hunting again and nearly snipped one out. Mans had the outside, curls back. Pushed to the floor though. Just a bomb of a hit by Hossack. Steamrolled him.
Not able to pick up the loose ball though.
Hit tight. Hill will bring that one to a close. Good luck by Toronto.
Hill had Toronto's number last game in Halifax when his team played, and certainly seems to be the case here again. Another big stop. Not just the number of saves, John, it's the, you know, the big timely ones.
Watson wanted to unload for the hat trick. Wouldn't that be something in his debut? Well, nearly snuck it through. Holichuk just got over to that post in time.
Cody Jamison thought that should have been back in. Challen Rogers must have got that ball out just in time.
Craig sets up the play. Rogers shoots, scores! The trailer Rogers makes good. And they've tied it up at 10.
What a game it's been for Challen Rogers. He's been all over the floor. Been handing out apples on the power play, been playing some great defense. This time he gets in on the goal scoring in transition. Again, Dan Craig playing a transition role here tonight. Rogers just uncorks that howitzer from the outside. The captain, too much time, too much space. He's gonna make you pay anytime you give him enough space to unload that absolute cannonade.
My math is right, and usually I'm better when it's not involved. That's 1 and 5 from Rogers tonight.
6 points. I'm not a big math guy either. But.
Yeah, you got it. We're working together on this. It's good. That's just number 25. Awesome. Good snipe.
Great job by Hossack. Tries to get the goal there, fights for the loose ball, gets it to safe space. That is a coach's dream.
Thunderbirds, changing the personnel.
Eric Fennell a little bit too overzealous on that pick.
Oh, Dilks wanted the fast break there. Won't find it though. Ripped wide off the boards and Hill came out and then a heavy, heavy collision. Dave Snow feeling that one as he goes back to the Toronto bench.
David Brock and DeSnew collided a few times here tonight.
Dropping the gloves earlier. Kyle Jackson taken down. Lost a chance. Over to Watson. Spreading out a little bit. And Halifax scores again. LeBlanc, yes, LeBlanc puts another one into the back of the net, and it just continues to be a seesaw battle in Hamilton.
Whether it's his family back home in Nova Scotia watching, or some of his family back here down the road in Dundas watching on TSN, gonna be a few fist pumps in the LeBlanc family room as he just unloads that shot. We'll see here, great pick there. Coming up, we'll get one more look at the celebration. Kyle Jackson all sorts of fired up for LeBlanc scoring against his former team. And again, I mentioned it, not a great start for him. He had 5 assists in his first couple of games, but just didn't look like himself. He has certainly found his stride in playing like that power forward we're used to seeing.
Easy for me to say. That might be the only one Hallichuk wants back tonight since he's come in.
He's been tremendous. We'll give him one. We'll give him one. I think there might have been a little bit of traffic in front of him as well, but...
Well, it just sets up a constant one-up type of game. See if the Rock can respond. Rogers to the side. It's in! Nice finish from Mans at the side to tuck it in the bed.
Boy, we talked about how the lefties needed to step up. And Mans and Craig have certainly done that tonight. Zach Mans. No fans in the stands. You know the turf here at First Ontario would be littered with hats as the good old Victoria boy quick stick in the back of the net. And I don't know if that's on the scouting report because Warren Hill's an unbelievable goaltender with great athleticism, but they keep feeding that backdoor pass for the quick stick, and it's worked a few times here tonight. Tie ball game. Now we're at 11-11.
Multiple hat tricks in this one, and Mann's the latest to put his name in that hat. And Dawson continues the milestone track. Another assist for Dan Dawson off a pretty goal for Mann's. Dan Dawson celebrating milestone game number 300, but he's working on another one in game, Pat.
Yes, that assist there on Rogers' goal. He is now tied for second in all-time scoring with one of his former teammates, John Grant Jr., a goat of this game, but I mean, Dawson, the best righty the game has ever seen. Not his best performance here tonight, but he keeps chipping away, and just like this Rock team, who keeps chipping away.
The tied several times, now at 11, and behind the play, there was Hossa getting involved, and now the Rock take the lead.
And it's Mans again, goal number 4. He's known as an outside shooter, a sharpshooter. But all his goals here tonight have been around the crease. This one, Rogers does a great job. Dodges past Bell, takes the shot, and once again, all alone on the crease, it's Mans, picks up the loose ball, Warren Hill with absolutely no chance, and the Rock take the lead, 12-11.
We're gonna have to get to the bottom of Baby Shark. I'm feeling there's a story there for Zach Mans. Goal song. That we've heard 4 times now. Big night for Mans. And draws in as well, and now we get a pretty good-looking board battle here. It's the first lead of this game for Toronto.
Yes. And we talked about it, John. They've had the ability to claw back in so many games this year, in the two losses, I should say. And they haven't had the chance to take over the game and take the lead. Now they've done it. We'll see if they can hold on to it.
Holichuk looked behind him. He's okay.
And Holichuk making a save on his coach from this past summer, Cody Jamieson, one of the coaches of the Six Nations Arrows. So.
And Rockford wins against Albany in Philadelphia, lost to Buffalo and these Thunderbirds along the way. Charging back are the Halifax Thunderbirds. Haven't been in this position, trailing by one. Shriver, room to rumble, he'll find it. Swings one across, Dawson going to work. Pick comes into play, goes all the way across with it though. Craig into the middle, Rogers wants another. He does have two, by the way. So after all that extensive math lesson we gave you,
two goals,
we harken back to the power play. And he was there.
8 points on the night. Just unbelievable stuff from John Rogers.
Such a steady influence on the game. In every sense.
Every aspect of the game. He's an absolute weapon.
Shaking free, Fennell. Oh, Chance actually fell out of the corner. Pardon me. Chance. Good looking crease drive.
Shanks almost getting another goal. He was really hot in that first half. It looks like Toronto's really starting to key on him. If Halifax wants to come back here in this second half, they got to get their shooters going once again.
Let's go down to Ashley. Bring her back in a couple of moments. Rock setting up. Rogers, all the way around off the glass. Play this one carefully. And now let's go down to Ashley.
Thanks, guys. One thing Matt Sawyer wanted from his team was sharpness. He said, a loose ball 2 minutes into a quarter matters. A good pass to start the offense matters. He didn't think his players were sharp enough in their game against Buffalo. And, of course, that's going to matter here right now as this game comes down to it. Everything you do potentially has a consequence, he said.
I don't know if the Rock will be content just to try and hang on. I'm guessing not. With 6.5 on the board, so absolutely it matters.
Extended possession here as Fennell grabs the loose ball. See if Halifax can capitalize on some tired defenders.
Watson up top. Dottie had made his way around Creed. Could not.
Fennell called for a moving pick there as bumps Cree a little too hard on the back there.
Bazooka, the other direction. Chopped at his Rogers. Ball comes out, although I'm not sure he ever really had it cleanly. In transition, Halifax moving up quickly. Jamieson looks over, and they'll find the time goal again. And I think Chance has another one.
Austin Shanks, have a night. Don't know if he's got the feed on the bench, but I said he started to cool down in the second half. He goes out there and rips an absolute snipe. But how about Cody Jamieson? Great job off the bench. Tarasenko with an assist here. Jamieson, wrong side of the floor. Doesn't matter. He's still dangerous from there. And then goes to the other side of the floor where the righty makes the Rock pay. Shanks. Boy, we knew he was going to have a big impact coming back on to this roster. But four goals here tonight. He's been nothing short of electric factory.
Shanks with four for Halifax. Vans with four. Just need to pluralize the name and you've got four goals. It's working out for everybody.
7 points for Shanks tonight. He's been awesome. Just simply awesome.
Here we are again, tied. This time at 12s. Five and a half to go. Quick stick doesn't work. To find the target that time. Looked like a good protection play, but what a steal and a shot there from Schreiber, forcing the issue.
Thompson has to be better with the ball. Been a couple of costly turnovers for him. Need to settle things down. Use your feet. You're a great athlete, Lindsay. Move the ball up the floor. Get it to safe space. Get your offense ready with the ball.
Walk sends this one bouncing off the glass. Jousting for it. West hand-eye coordination by Boucher there to try and make something out of nothing. And it's been that kind of game, so why not try it? 12 goals aside. Four from Shanks to tie it up yet again. Take a look at tonight's Save the Game, presented by Alterna Savings.
And at first glance, this might look like just a little casual save for Warren Hill, but this second look here makes the initial stop, and whoop! Just a little kick save and a beauty from Warren Hill. We talked about how he's a big body, a big presence in the net, but he has some sneaky athleticism.
It's not quite a scorpion, so is it a crawfish?
I think so.
I don't know if that's catchy enough to make its way around here, but that was something, that's for sure, with the right.
I know he likes his seafood chowder when they go out in Halifax. Maybe a shrimp, a lobster tail.
A lobster tail. Love it. That's why we paid the big bucks. Vance, is there more? On the line. Hill's got that one.
Boy, Hill has been unbelievable, especially in the second half. He's really held down the fort. Things have certainly gotten sloppy here for Halifax in the second half, and I think that maybe we talked about how endurance could come into play. They haven't played in 36 days. Wheels starting to fall off a little bit, but we saw that punch back as they tied things up at 12.
They try to hang around. Remember, they don't have a blemish on their record yet, 2-0. Feels like forever, and it has been 30-plus days since they played last in week two against the same Rock Club. Rogers in the corner. Dawson distributes. Burner from the line, and that one just missed.
Great shot by Schreiber, just missing the net. I don't even know if Hill saw
it. I don't
that.
Think he did. He heard it behind him. Watson. Pretty good look here. Question is, did he get airborne enough? No.
Kyle Jackson, the Michigan man, still looking for his first goal of the season. He's got a ton of chances. Just not getting the luck, not getting the bounces to find the back of the net.
Weir hands off to Craig. Back up top. Nice stop by Hill. Point blank look. Right down the pipe. walking up the middle, Craig. Peering over his shoulder, tries to make something happen, goes behind with it. Man's on the move. Picks it back out, Craig. Right in tight, Dawson scores! And he's got it! What a career mark for Dan Dawson to punctuate with that goal.
It's history in Hamilton as Dan Dawson surpasses John Grant Jr. for second in all-time NLL scoring. The best right-hander forward that we've ever seen in the history of the game. And this is just peak Dan Dawson. Uses that big body, boxes out his man, and it's those silky mitts in tight as he beats Warren Hill to give his team a lead late here in the fourth quarter.
Have a day, Dan. Look at those numbers. Gotti. 14-47 for Dan Dawson. Second all time. See if that propels the Rock. Up a goal again. Armstrong has lots of time, but no support yet. Gonna slow it up. Off the bench. Shank scores! That was a cobra strike from Shanks, who just laser beamed it right in there.
Austin Shanks does not want to lose this lacrosse game. He is willing his team here in the fourth. Just keeps chipping away. Things aren't going great for the offense. What does he do here? He takes the ball, sees an isolation against Noble, takes it. Again, you have to close the gap when Austin Shanks has the ball. And if you don't, he's going to make you pay. There is barely even a release there. That's how good of a shooter he is. In the back of the net. And once again, the Thunderbirds are not going away. And it's a big part because of number 33 right there.
Keep going up the mountain here, tied at 13 now. Austin Shanks, how about his fifth of the game? My goodness.
Prayers Forever took the under as well, just saying.
I don't remember that conversation. It's all good. Steele here puts Halifax back on the attack.
Massive loose ball by Jake Withers there.
Those are the slip-ups you don't want to see this late in the game.
No, exactly. And Ashley said, this is what they've been working on practice. Sharpness.
Holler, Chuck, what a stop for the Rock to keep it tied.
He's made a ton of stops. That might be the best one yet.
Craig dishes over, trying to go up top. Was Dawson again denied by Hill.
40 years old Dan Dawson still diving for loose balls. That's the separation that makes him such a special generational player. Yeah, sure, he can put the ball in it. Yeah, he's a great playmaker. Yeah, he's been playing for a billion years, but it's the fire. Yes, he lost the loose ball, but he still was fighting for loose balls.
Put that one on the mantle. Playing for a billion years, I love it. Shanks in. Does he have six? Up top. Well missed. That one doesn't. Hollichuk forced into a stop. And we are 27 seconds away for some free lacrosse, everybody.
That's, of course, if Toronto has something to say about it. They'll take a timeout here as Rusty Kruger, the offensive coordinator of this Rock team, will chalk something up. You see him right there.
NLL on TSN is brought to you in part by Alterna Savings. Alterna offers easy, more personal financial services and puts the good in banking. Visit alterna.ca to learn more. By fanatics.ca, the NLL's home for officially licensed everything. Visit fanatics.ca today. And by Guaranteed Rate. If you believe it, you can do it. Guaranteed Rate. Believe you will.
Go into the mind of coach Pat Gregoire for a moment. What are you scheming up with 27 seconds on the board?
This is not good because I'm a defensive coach, so. But you got to think that backdoor feed has been working nice. That skip pass from either on the shooter from Schreiber to the crease, or even we've seen Rodgers from the point go to that skip pass. But you've also got to be thinking, defensive coach Billy D saying that's what's been working. So that's probably your first look, but I would not be surprised if they try to get something, free a shooter out in the middle with that extra attacker. Or you also have the option of Chandler Rogers, who can just uncork a cannon and put one in the back of the net.
Holichuk on the bench, game on the line. Rogers carries it up. Fans. Dawson, you can see him motioning, just slow it down. Want one look? Craig Rogers shoots. And they don't get that look they were hoping for.
It actually looks like they were looking to get behind the net for that dunk from Schreiber, which we haven't seen here tonight, but we saw them do it a lot in their home opener in their win against Albany, but weren't able to get that done.
So Holichuk comes back in. Halifax calls a timeout. They have even less to work with on the clock, of course, but
can't take the timeout into overtime. Mike Akurzy saying they called the timeout. He wants more, making sure that there's more time on the clock. I don't know how much they honestly had, John, to be quite honest.
Looked like a four, but we'll find out.
Matt Sawyer disagreeing, thinking it should be a closer to a two, maybe. But they will have to start possession down the other end. Cody Jamison going to start with the ball, so expect maybe a long bomb. Try to see if something crazy can happen here. There's only, looks like.
Well, there you go. It's a two, not a four.
Matty Sawyer was right. Jamison has such a unique release. Look to see him throw a little bit of English on this ball.
Hustling up, thrown in, it's Kempton over top of the left shoulder of Holichuk. That was a razor, but it stays tied. What a lacrosse game we've enjoyed with you, and there's more in store. Overtime is coming up for the NLL Game of the Week on TSN. Been a terrific back and forth night, and we're headed to overtime. Pat, how did we get there?
Well, Dan Dawson looked like his perfect night, passing John Grant Jr. for second in all-time scoring. Was going to be the game winner, but the night Austin Shanks is having, he said, nah, this thing ain't over. Ties it all up at 13. Now we're going to lacrosse. You know what's better than lacrosse, John? Free lacrosse.
Sign me up. Every week? Let's do it every week. 13 goals, Toronto and Halifax respectively. Nearly half of them came from that man,
yes,
on the Halifax side.
And I know there's some folks in the lacrosse world that say, you know what, face-offs don't really matter. Well, tell either one of these coaches that face-offs don't matter right now. Two of the best in the biz going at it, fighting for possession, and this possession could be key, as it's a sudden death overtime. Next goal wins.
Getting it sized up. in Hamilton. Thanks for being with us on the NLL Game of the Week. All big in the standings, but certainly for Toronto after dropping one last week to Buffalo. OT underway early. Uncharacteristic move to send it back in that fashion. And Toronto will take a timeout.
No doubt about that. And there you go. That's the possession. There's a bit of a scramble for that loose ball. Gets kicked all the way back. Billy Hosterhauser picks up loose ball to call a timeout. So again, Toronto going to try to chalk something up here, end this game as quickly as they can, not allow Halifax to get an opportunity here. Halifax already this season with an overtime win. Their first win of the season came against Saskatchewan. They have been no stranger to the overtime game, even dating back to their first season in Halifax. Had another crazy, crazy game against Saskatchewan. We'll see if we maybe have an instant classic here.
There's plenty of players to choose from, given the numbers in this game. See if the timeout pays off for Toronto.
We'll have to wait and see if Troy Holichuk comes out of his cage to send that extra attacker at any point, or if they'll decide to stay 5-on-5. But it's going to be Dawson who's going to start with the rock.
Dawson leading it up in overtime. Shriver with Rogers setting it up. Shriver goes to the side. Mans. Couple of whacks over to Dawson. Rogers. Back up top. In tight for Dawson. You can see what the body language was intended to do. Just couldn't keep the ball cradled.
That was perfect defense for about 27 seconds, and then a little bit of a miscue on the back end, and Dawson almost had the game on his stick.
Well, Halifax turn to have an offensive possession in OT. Jameson runs right into his own man. Ball pops free. Not the opportunity Toronto hoped it would be. Jameson again. Over to the far side. What a block there. And a scoop to boot.
Mitch Disnew, that's got to be number 3, 4. I don't know. He's blocked a ton of shots here tonight.
Rogers. Shriver and Dawson. Hands moving in. Shriver pauses. Works down low. Back to Rogers. Missed it, but he'll get some support. Craig. Trying to deke his way into some free space, runs right into a roadblock though. And
it's a tough soak there by Tyson Bell, a gritty player.
Halifax will set it up again. Bushi over to the side. Jackson in tight! Off the post, boy, that was close from Bushi on the net drive.
Austin Shanks, I think, took the shot there. The way he's been shooting, it looked like he can't miss. He beats Holichuk, but not the pipe.
So Shanks, excuse me, with Bushi in tight there as well. Rogers, see if the Rock can use their extra life. Backhander! And Hill takes that one away from Cochran, trying to play hero.
Cochran, what a welcome that would have been to the team. Getting his first goal in style and in overtime. That's again, Halifax playing great defense, but just with a couple of seconds left, just getting a little bit lost there and allows Toronto to get a shot off.
Jameson, curling. A block from long range, and Holichuk, no problem with that one.
Great defensive stand by Toronto, not giving much up there.
From his knees, Craig keeps it alive. Rogers now. Wait for positioning. Shriver. Craig zapped that one, but not on its mark. Fast break here for Halifax.
trying to finish it. Hossick, and he was in behind everybody, but couldn't find the back of the net.
Hossick's become so deadly in transition over the past couple of seasons. He's going to want that one back. He's usually money on those breakaways, but big stop by Holichuk.
Dawson leaning on his man. Breaks free. Dawson. Keeping the stick free. Drives. Dawson. Hot down. Shoots. And a stop by Hill. Determination from Dan Dawson on that. Last opportunity. Halifax moving up. Jackson switches, then dives, and Holichuk grabbed that one. Pushing over to his right. Thunderbirds with it. Bushi missed. He thought he had it sewn up. Looks to the Raptors after that miss.
But Jackson may have got a shot off there. It looks like he got it off, but not onto the cage. There wasn't a reset there.
Overtime. Moving quickly. Driver. Wants to finish this one. Hill shuts down a crank drive. Crank gets it back though. Rock changing it behind the play. Rogers back out there. Dawson takes a breather. Shriver. Dawson in overtime. Keeping his eyes peeled. Rogers works his way to the front. Dawson finds some room thanks to Shriver. Shoots! Denied by Hill down low. Two big looks by Dawson and OT.
This Halifax defense just looks absolutely gassed. John, you talked about it, how Mike Kersey earlier in the week said he did not want, you know, their conditioning to come into effect. But 36 days off, you can work out in the gym as much as you can, go for a run. You can't. You just simply cannot emulate what it is like game shape here.
So doing his best to keep it in is Warren Hill. Look at these.
And that one there, I think, went off the pipe. But we'll get another look here as his other chance is Dawson trying to will his team to victory. No doubt there, Warren Hill making the stop. He has been unbelievable here tonight. Facing 61 shots. Woo. Talk about conditioning coming into play. Well, he might be a big lad. He's in unbelievable shape.
Order him an ice bath after this one, but we've still got some game left. John Abbott, Pat Gregoire, and Ashley Docking.
We can't talk about goaltending without talking about Troy Holichuk. In his first start, that has been a theme here in the National Lacrosse League in the past couple of weeks. Holichuk, the latest coming into his first start, and he's been unreal.
Next supported Rose. Came in early in the game to Holichuk, and you're right, dynamite ever since. First appearance. He'll be tested here off a skipper. Rock trying to push up quickly.
Might have been the look that they wanted, but not the right execution. Shanks' shot gets blocked.
Rogers. Dish off this time. Shriver. Working from the outside in. Wants that opening. Spin shot blocked. Loose ball. Juggled. Dilks is on it. Halifax recovers.
Great loose ball by Luke Magnon as he limps to the bench. That's the grinder plays you love to see from your defense.
Hossick set it up. Holichuk to save. Back up the floor. Come to Rock in overtime. The Snoo. For Dawson on to Rogers. Rogers tangled up, threw a one-handed over the man's, hoping he'd find him. Thunderbirds pepper up the floor now. LeBlanc didn't find the
target he was looking for.
Something's got to give here, John. Holton's potent offense just can't seem to find the back of the net here in overtime.
Driver. Man, some room. Leaps. Can't put it under Hill.
They call him the king of the hill in Halifax. And boy, he has been on his throne tonight. Another big stop here in OT.
Jameson gives the attack a little bit of time. Jameson circles, shoots. What a bullet. Ripped wide. Jameson wanted to finish it right there, no question about it. Dawson in overtime. Two good looks. Rogers. In, shoots. Now passes over. They jam it up. Thought they had it, but Hill and the net able to keep this game going for Halifax.
I think they might take a second look at this. No, as we can see, you can't see it at home, folks, but on the Jumbotron here at the arena, it looks like the red flag's going to come out. I think they're going to challenge this one.
Are they saying inside of the bar? They're pretty confident.
Matt Sawyer is convinced.
Shriver would take it to finish this game.
Shriver. And that one does not look like that. We'll get a great look here, John. Nope. And the net does move, so obviously you still have to keep... It's not like hockey when the net's off, it's blown down. It keeps that natural goal line
plane.
Still
right.
Did not cross that plane. I mean, I would have been concerned. I thought Driver, before he left off, might have actually stepped into the crease before. Regardless, Chris Williams, the official, the crew chief, is taking a look at it. I don't think that's a goal.
I hope they're seeing the tip of the stick come into play as well, maybe, but yeah, I mean, very close. I thought Rogers was going to shoot that ball, to be perfectly honest with you.
I mean, the way he's been shooting, passing, I mean, the guy's been doing it all tonight. We'll see it one more time there. It's that one's not in, and again, with the net moving off, it keeps that natural goal line, and it still has to cross the plane, which it does not. The crew chief, Chris Williams, making sure Shriver taking a look, talking.
The ball never crossed the goal line, no goal.
Well, quick description after a lengthy review, and so we play on.
They're going to remain with possession as that errant pass went into the bench, so they're going to still have an opportunity to end it here, John.
See if they can accomplish that. Craig, over to Rogers. Good luck there, back behind the net. There's the same play by Shriver, and Hill was ready for it.
Great move by Shriver to fake he was going to go the other side, went back around, but Hill stood strong, made the big stop.
LeBlanc on the ball for Halifax. Nearly to Fennell, instead to Peterson. Bouchy, spread it out. They score, LeBlanc! A blazer past Holochuk, and Halifax finds their second win of the season against the Rock in overtime.
The veteran Steph LeVoy Plastis from his birthplace in Dundas, Ontario. A shot from the outside you have to feel for Troy Holichuk. He was unbelievable tonight, and it's unfortunate a goal like that goes in past him. But the Halifax Thunderbirds find a way to come out with a victory here. A gritty, gritty performance. We'll see it right here, Holichuk. And that one might have went off the back of Desnoux, but it certainly caught Holichuk off guard as he shoots that on the run and goes in the back of the net. John, as they say, good teams find ways to win when even things aren't going your way, and I think that's the case here for tonight. Halifax stole one.
Well, a former member of the Rocks, Steph LeBlanc, burns him in OT, and the Thunderbirds have 3 wins, 2 against the Rock. Let's go down to Ashley.
Thank you so much, you guys. I'm here with Steph LeBlanc. Okay, the overtime winner. You guys obviously had a long overtime. How much will and resolve does it take to keep pressing against a Toronto team that wasn't giving an inch?
They certainly weren't. That was a great back and forth. You know, you never see overtimes go that long in lacrosse. So I'm absolutely exhausted and happy that it's over.
Talk to me a little bit about Warren. He had over like 60 saves, something ridiculous. He's been really strong for you guys again and again.
Yeah, and they got some shooters, so he's been our horse. When the moment's big, he plays his best, so kudos to him. He kept us in it tonight.
And for you, a hat trick, 3 goals. How does it feel to kind of get in the flow of the offense for yourself and be able to contribute in such a meaningful way?
Yeah, it's been, first 2 games, I was kind of on the schneid, so just really happy to contribute. And, you know, our left side's been struggling, and I think we got 5 or 6 on the left side. So that creates a little bit more balance on the offense, makes us a little bit less predictable. So that's good.
Thanks, Steph. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
All right, you guys, that was a long game. I'm sure you're exhausted and can use a drink of water. Take us home.
Thank you, Ashley. You know what? It's great when we're out of words, because you know that means it's been a good lacrosse game. This had something for everybody here tonight. Pat, my goodness, goals aplenty, a back and forth play, and a big finish after it looked like the Rock had climbed back into this lacrosse game as well.
Absolutely, an electric game, a huge victory for Halifax. You could see that 36 days off certainly came to play. The wheels fell off, but they had the resolve to continue to push and push. But you got to feel for the Toronto Rock, another loss for them in their division, but you have to like the fight that they had with them. A lot of guys out of the lineup with COVID protocol, but the play of Troy Holichuk, he kept this team in it when things were going sour near the start. An unbelievable game from 2 division foes.
Lots of first NLL goals, lots of goals from multiple players. Good goaltending, and man, it was fantastic. Dan Dawson celebrating milestone night on 2 occasions, second all time, and it was capped with a Thunderbirds win. They last played in week 2 against Toronto, took the victory, and did it again in week 7 in overtime. Thanks for watching our NLL Game of the Week on TSN.